All right, so here we are again, down Phoenix, and we're checking out some more 341 real game, is what it calls on the menu, but it says Super Games 341 on the cartridge. Don't forget to check out the two previous episodes where I show off the cartridge and what the list of games are and so on. These are just episodes just checking out some of the games, mainly the ones that we know that either aren't real NES games or they weren't, like, released in the U.S., Hexa, never even heard of that one. Pretty, okay. So they're using the Tetris music, but they're using, I have no idea what this is, man. It doesn't look legit to me. Yeah. Alright, ice hockey, that's a good one. Lot Lot, we never had Lot Lot. Lot Lot! The freaking hell is this? What is this? I don't understand. I can hit A and it makes our thumbs things spin or whatever. I don't have a freaking clue. Ah, man. This game is like the game of rocket science. Like, can you practice rocket science? If so, you can play Lot Lot. Alright, so we have Pikachu. We know there is no such thing as an NES Pokemon game. It's got a lot of multiplayer modes. What? It's a freaking Tetris-type game, man. That's all there is. And you can't spin... Okay, you can spin the blocks. Why is your blocks only have two? This does not make sense. These Chinese ROM hackers, they don't know Tetris, apparently. They don't know how Tetris is supposed to function. Yeah, this is stupid. This is like baby's first Tetris, man. Alright, let's check out Ninja 2. It's another ninja game. I actually play as a ninja in this one. I have no freaking idea what this is. This could not have been a US release game. There's no freaking way. I have no idea what it's called if it is. Yeah, that's just downright silly, dude. We never checked out Astro Robo Sasa. Might as well. Cool. Pretty cool, I suppose. I'm just thinking it's like gonna be an arcade type game. Oh, this is like actually really cool, man. So this is kind of like a variation of Balloon Fighter or something like that. Or Joust. So, yeah, I like this one, dude. This one's not bad. It's got a good little gameplay hook. Like, that's all you gotta do is just make sure to pop the balloons and stuff, and you got, like, a little bit of physics modeling going on there. I'm not sure what the E is supposed to represent, but... time, possibly? Let me grab some E whenever we did that, so... yeah, it's a nice little game. Alright, no idea what Obaki is. Okay, let's check it out. Definitely a Japan-only one. Or, I don't know, if it came out in the U.S., I had no idea what it... Actually, I think I might know what game this is, now that I think about it. I'll go ahead and put the title in if I think about it. Kind of like a shoot step. Now die, you freaking dog. Oh, I guess not. Dog will not die. Oh, you fly in this one. Okay. Why is that dog shooting stuff? Alright, Onyanko Town. Never heard of that one. The hell is this? This is a funky looking game, man. That's a weird ass jumping animation. I guess you could jump over the enemies, I guess that's what you gotta do. Looks like we're playing as a cat, and we're being chased by dogs in a Pac-Man-like maze. There's a little cone. Can't do anything with it. Whatever. Fish! Clearly we need the freaking fish. What?! Patchycom? No idea what that is. Seems like a weird one. Oh, shit. I think I know what this might be. This is like Konami's kind of favorite games now. I think. Why is it adding all this time? I just want to play the freaking game. I would say this looks like a pachinko kind of game. Like they tried to do a pachinko game on the NES, but I can't figure out how to get it to do anything. It just adds time. Well, hold on, what was that? What did I just do there? I did something. Apparently, I can hold the A button and make that little thing move slightly, and sometimes a little ball comes out. Wait, hold on. How do you... I think this is supposed to be a pachinko game. No idea how you do it. Yeah, this is pachinko. That's right, bitches. I don't know how I did it, but I did it. I got it figured out. Yeah, you have to... So you have to basically hold the A button and use the directional pad, and it kind of like moves things around. You have to, it's like pachinko. You're supposed to hit certain targets and things like that to accomplish your scores and whatnot. See, we started with 100. I think that's supposed to represent the number of balls we have. Yep, see, there we go. Doing some motherfucking pachinko on the NES. Surprise, people. This was a thing way back in the day. This isn't just a Konami thing nowadays. Yeah, it was really interesting that we had a pachinko game on the NES. I would have thought the pachinko was probably a little bit too complicated to do that. Pyramid doesn't really sound like a real game. Cool cover art, though. The fuck? Did it talk? This has to be like a third-party game. Like one of those ones from back in the day. No idea what the objective is, if it's just a... Yeah, this game's shitty. We never checked out B-Wings. That doesn't sound like a real video game. I guess you get to choose different power-ups for your ship? Why did I jettison my power-up then? The fucking hell is this game, man? B-Wings! It doesn't even seem like a legit game, dude. So messed up. What's up with the background? Look at the freaking background. It's just a freaking checkerboard looking thing. That's all it is. I guess let's try a cannon. Don't press whatever button that makes us jettison the power up. Oh, it's B that made us jettison it. So I guess that B is supposed to represent some kind of dodging thing or something. I guess it's a real game, man. It looks legit, just... I never even heard of this one. B-Wing, man. It's the weirdest ass name for a game. I mean, I guess I figured it had to be a flying game if it was named that, but... Jeez. Check out Route 16. Oh yeah, I think I know this game. The fuck? Where am I at? This game is super fucked up, man. You get in the little menu, and you're like a little tiny-ass dot here. I guess I'm the little blue dot, the cyan dot or whatever. Yeah, that's what we are. Yeah, fuck this game. Those all look legit otherwise. Let's see. Sansan, that doesn't sound like a real game. Sansan. They got freaking Sudoku on here, really. Man, that's Sprite Flicker, holy crap. Let's go Tenjiku. Oh shit, this is a real game. This is just a Japan-only one, I guess. Pretty good so far that you're playing as a monkey shooting shit. Nothing wrong with that. Very good controls, very fluid. Lot of sprite flicker, but understandable since there's a lot of shit going on, apparently. Music's not very good, though. It's really, really lame. Just gotta avoid the enemy AIs there. I can't hit fire buttons, apparently, because it's the A button, and my A button gets stuck. Actually, we never even looked at Antarctic Adventure, now that I think about it. And 90 Tank? What the hell is 90 Tank? Tank A, 1990. Okay, that's a weird game. Well, we should have looked at before. Guess we can't shoot through that projectile thing. It had a construction thing, which I guess it meant that it has like a little thing where you can construct your levels and stuff. So that's kind of cool. It's like a Excitebike kind of crap. Sound is terrible in this though, man. Holy crap. It's all over the place. The sound effects. Dude, that sound is just freaking awful. Let's get back to where we were there. There's a game called Squoon. I think I've heard of that. Spartan X. That sounds familiar. What's that? I think it's a Japanese version of something. Oh, yeah, it's a Japanese version of Kung Fu. Why'd they call it Spartan X? That's... I guess it works, sort of. Actually, no, it doesn't. This has nothing to do with Spartans. It's freaking Kung Fu. Why didn't you guys just call it Kung Fu? That's what it is. Everybody loves Kung Fu, though, man. It's a good game. But it's like one of those games, like, after the first stage, it just gets super ridiculously hard and it's stupid. It might have to be a game I'll have to cover on a future series I'm going to be doing. Which actually... You probably have already seen the first episode of it by now. Who knows? Depends on when I uploaded it. Well, whatever, it's Kung Fu. So we got Super Mario, Tetris, Dexter, now Volgar 2, not sure what that is. Apparently we can make the step scroll? Not sure why. I think there may be something wrong with this particular one or something. Like, why did this stuff scroll there? No idea what the objective is here. Holy crap, projectiles! Guess it's just a crappy shmup. That's all it is. The fact that I'm still alive is pretty perplexing, honestly. I'm surprised with all this crap going on. Which, I guess to this game's credit at least, there is not any flicker. At least very little flicker. Given how many projectiles and sprites are on the screen, that's impressive, but seems like a really boring game otherwise. Plus, apparently, running into things doesn't really kill me. It actually makes me more powerful. That does not make any sense. Why am I gaining POW by running into ships? This does not make sense, man. There's apparently a little gray sec. What the hell is going on? This does not make sense. Okay. I guess when that number counts to 100, you're dead. Whatever. Alright, let's check out Star Luster. That doesn't seem like a game we're accustomed to. Training, Command, Adventure. Let's just check out Training. Mission, destroy all enemies and defend the universe. Oh, you know what? I think this is a game that we had in the U.S. I think it's called Destination Earth or something like that. I think that's the one. It's supposed to be like a really weird, let's just go here, I guess. Yeah, I think this will take us to like where we actually have enemies. Yeah, now we'll have a segment where we actually do some spaceship fighting. I don't know, maybe this is not Destination Earth, but this is like a game that's a similar game in scope. Like, you go around warping and stuff like that. Like, this is the kind of game that originally was like Star Raiders and Star Master, you know, from Atari. It's like that kind of game. It's an old-school, arcade-ish space dogfighting game. So, the radar doesn't seem like it works very good in this one. But yeah, we got the enemy there. The radar is really weird in this game. I can't really ascertain what that's about. Oh, okay, I guess that's being set, they're in that direction. That makes sense then. Yeah, this is a kind of weird game for sure, man. Blast this freaking Death Star, hell yeah! I guess we killed all the enemies, yep. Alright, so let's see what else we got here. We got Volleyball Wars. Not the kind of title screen is expected for a game called Wars, but okay. The fucking hell is this? Is this like a... What is this? Is it like a dodgeball game? This is a Japan game, clearly. Oh, maybe it could even be a Chinese ROM hack. Yeah, this is freaking dodgeball, man. It's actually kind of cool that there's a dodgeball game on the NES, you know, kind of. I mean, it's super bare bones. Why are we playing as a penguin? I got hit. I lost this. Why did he lose when he got hit? Huh? Why? Oh, it's not about... Okay. It's about getting all the... Okay. I get it now. Challenger. See what that is. Real-time action adventure. How about you just show us a game? We'll determine if that's true. Stop the Express. Okay. This game looks screwed up, dude. Yeah, rub it in our faces at the train left. Okay. Kill the birds first. I fell off the train, I suppose. No idea why this game is called Challenger. It doesn't make sense. Kill the bird. Jump. I guess I gotta jump to the next train car. Kill this guy. Just randomly throw fucking daggers at people. Yeah, fuck this game. So, we've got Sudoku, which I'm sure is Sudoku. I don't know why it wouldn't be. Faded Pirate. Never heard of that one. Okay. Okay, I died, I guess. I really don't know what the point is. B shoots, A shoots, different objects. I don't know. A cat's in the TV screen. Hey, what's up, Cole? Cole, look. Right here, buddy. Right here. He is looking, but he doesn't care. He just wants to get his ass up there. I have no idea about this game. This game's stupid. Oh, you hit start, apparently, to move. That doesn't make sense. Yeah, this game's stupid. But I guess we're knocking all the enemy ships out now. Guess you guys can't see it because my cat's there. Hey, what's up, Cole? Yeah. It's more interesting in this game, honestly. Yeah, this is stupid. Final Blood. That sounds like a good one. Okay, this is a weird game. I have no idea. Okay, wait, tanks. Kill the enemy tanks. So he's gotta spin around, I guess, and shoot shit. I really don't think this is a legit game, man. This, I mean, it looks okay enough. It doesn't have that typical Chinese ROM hack look, but this has to be a Chinese ROM hack, dude. There's no way this is legit. I mean, just listen to that freaking music. That's Chinese ROM hack music city. And I really don't know what the point of this game is. Yeah, this game sucks. The time doesn't even count down in a real fashion. 2.4, and the time has not moved at all this entire time. 2.3 now. For some reason, the time just randomly changed. I don't know, maybe it is on a base time interval, but it was like going down a lot quicker earlier. I just don't know what the point of this game is, man. This doesn't make a lot of sense. When I was thinking Final Blood, I was thinking, surely this is like the Rambo video game or some crap, but no. It's this. This is Final Blood. A game that nobody fucking wanted with music that nobody ever wanted to hear. Fish Story? That does not sound like a real game. Title screen looked okay, though. What the freaking hell? Oh, okay, you can eat fish. I guess avoid the bigger fish. Yeah, it's his Fish Story, I guess. I'll give credit where it's due, but I just don't see what the point of this is. Wait, is that a good thing to grab those fish? It changed my fish. So I can't take this fish on now? Nope. Okay, well that's Fish Story, whatever. Really getting into some weird games here. Man, this is just crazy. Let's check out Fling Ball. The hell is Fling Ball? I was probably saying most of these games, like, what the hell is this game? So am I supposed to attack the enemy? I don't know what this game is, man. Oh, he caught the ball, okay. Common's attacking now? Oh, okay. I get it, I suppose. This is like the stupidest ass game though, man. To be able to guess where he's gonna... Yeah, this is fucking retarded. Forest Adventure, that is definitely not a legit game. There's no way, man. Yeah, this has Chinese ROM hack written all over it, man. Oh, maybe it's a legit game, but... I just don't know, man. Fortunately, the platform is with the A button on my controller, which is a shame. Because the button sticks. NES gamer problems. It actually plays pretty good. This is a good playing game. It's just Chinese ROM hack music, man. I freaking hate it. Makes you want to slice your ears off. So we've got Fruit Gift. Let's see what Fruit Gift is. Okay. I guess it's a matching game of some type. I'm not sure how to match, though. Okay, yeah, it is. I guess that's a watermelon? I guess you just use the D-pad. That's all I gotta do there. I do not see a watermelon. Did the game just auto-fail me by giving me a fruit that's not even on the freaking plate? How do I get an apple? There's not an apple, dude. What a stupid-ass game. Ghost Castle? Chinese ROM hack. Golden Bird. Nice looking title screen. Apparently I'm playing as this blue dude though. I guess you gotta free the birds. It looks like just a simple maze dodge type game. You just gotta dodge them up. I still got hit with terrible collision detection. Guess they're just ripping sound effects off of, like, Galaga and shit like that, man. Those are definitely Namco sound effects. Why not rip off some good music, too? This game sounds like fucking ass to the ears. We've got Greeds. That's not a real game. There's no freaking way it is. It's another variation of Snake. If you want a Snake that has a smaller thing, then this is it. Hammer and Nail. Yeah, this is what you do. You hammer a nail, bitches. It's a projective, or projective. The perspective it was absolutely garbage. This could actually be a possibly fun game with crappy Chinese ROM hack music, of course, but... Yeah. Alright, happy match. Okay, looks like it's a matching game. Perfect for the kiddos. Fantastic. Ah, oh, jeez. The perfect NES game for your 3-year-old. Let's check out Ice Ocean. Okay, what's going on here? Fantastic! Well, let's check out Ice Ocean again. Second time's a charm, right? So we're really down to like 337 games, because we had a couple duplicates I've noticed, and the Ice Ocean doesn't even fucking work, so let's check out IQ Champion. Dongzian Techno presents IQ Champion. This is definitely a Chinese ROM hack game, but who knows? They might have put some effort into it. I'm not sure what this has to do with IQ. This is just a shmup. And not even a very good one. If I was Dongzi and whatever his name was, I would not have put my name on this shit. I've been like, nope, I had nothing to do with this one. Not me. But I'll give credit where due. They tried. I can't program NES games, so I guess, technically I'm shittier than they are. Alright, Island. There's just a game called Island, that's all it's called. Nature Clan Island. Okay. Seems legit enough. Like, Kickle Cubicle in a way. It reminds me of that in a bit. I mean, Kickle Cubicles is a lot better, because it doesn't have Chinese ROM hack music, but same gameplay otherwise. Plus, it had more actual strategy and things happening, you know, that's another important thing to point out. I don't know what the objective here is, but... Yeah. And I think the last one for this video, we'll check out one more game. And we'll have to do another part because my phone's battery is actually getting pretty low. I need to take a little bit of a break, let it get charged up and stuff like that. So let's check out Jump Jump. Jump Jump. Yep. Another ROM hack. Doesn't even have fucking sound or music. Well, that's excellent. Oh, okay, it does. Okay, it does. Just no music and no jumping sound effects. Don't grab the turtles, I guess. The scrolling's actually kind of weird. In a good way, though. It's like, it's got some interesting scrolling mechanics. This game plays like it's a beta test of something, though. It's like not a real game. I guess the objective is to get to the top of the waterfall before the time expires, I suppose. I guess that's as good as objective as any. It's really weird, though, because like the way you jump... Guess don't grab the red things. The red fruits are bad. The green fruits are good. Don't touch the enemies also. And always, always jump up the waterfall. And this dude is like the fattest freaking character in NES history. Yeah. I don't know. It's not a terrible game, honestly. It's a lot better than most of the other Chinese ROM hack games we've had. Like, this is one that... could have been an actual NES game in maybe like an alpha stage. Like they were still working out some kinks, but they had a good gameplay hook and, you know, they were just building off it. But for whatever reason, the game got canceled. That's kind of what this game reminds me of in a way. So, thanks for checking out this episode, guys. Don't forget to check out the other episodes we've covered. Till then, Down Phoenix out.